does not pay attention to the vowels. The male does not pay attention to those vowels. The female does. So you ask a male, you say, can you repeat the part of the vows? You know, not dearly beloved, we are gathered here to witness and all of face and the thing, you know. Good. I duly, justly, solely promise to cherish. The male can remember cherish. The male can remember honor, love, and then you say, what else? And they say, till death do us part. Now, when you ask the female, you say, do you remember the vows? She says, yes. You say, well, what do you remember? She says, obey. You say, what about it? I said, well, he's obeying. And he better obey. And that is how you become the boss. Because you get the male to obey. He's got to obey. I mean, he just doesn't have anything else to do. Obey. And it's a funny sounding word, obey. Sounds like pig Latin. Obey. Obey. Oh yay, obey. Anyway, my wife is the boss, and as I said before, I don't want her job. I've seen it. It's a horrible job. And I still don't understand how she's going to outlive me. Because anybody who's got to deal emotionally with those people and can still outlive me, there's something wrong with me. I must be sick. Let me give you an example of what I call the same thing happens every night. It's supper time. Do you have children? How old? They're grown now. But how many did you have? Two. Okay. That qualifies. Qualifies. Because a person with one child, I don't call them really a parent. Because there are too many things left out. If you just have one child, there are too many things left out. For instance, if something's broken in the house, you have one child, you know who did it. See, you don't have to go through. You know the child did it. Also, people with one child do not have to go through, will you stop touching me? I mean, if you got one child and the child's doing that, then you got to take it away, you know.